say. I wouldn't call myself skeptical because I was one of the last generation to work maybe on analog tape before all the digital, the ADATs came out for home recording. And so because of convenience, we switched over to digital. It's more convenient. You can make records at your house with ADATs. Then these DAW started coming out, Cubase, Pro Tools, Logic, digital performer. And so because of convenience, we kind of went down that path. And digital converters definitely got better and better and better. And so then when Chris and Amy Estes called me and told me about CLASP, I'm like, yeah, that's cool, but that's we got to buy tape. You can have hiss. It's going to be difficult to work on. It's going to take a long time to rewind the tape and all that stuff. And so they were very gracious enough and allowed us to actually try CLASP out. We recorded at Quad Studio on SSL-J, if I'm not mistaken. And so he brought CLASP in, set up like that. Worked great. To me, it was a difference that I hadn't heard in probably over 10 years. But then once I thought, okay, the real test is when I come home back to my mix room and I can check it out. And it was definitely a groundbreaking ooh-ah experience. To me, it's like we're actually making music again. I know that's a hard thing to say, but to me, it seems like analog tape presents itself to where we're more emotionally moved by whatever is recorded. It wasn't as much of a mathematical, calculated sound that had a life of its own. A lot of the things that are modeled or modeled after trying to get true tape compression, and when you definitely have the real thing, it's a big difference. Let me give you a quick example. We came back to this studio. We set up CLASP in our environment because we were so moved by it. We worked it out in the budget where we just bought a CLASP. But the real test was on our own turf. So we ended up, set CLASP up the night before tracking. It came time to test the bass tone. And Chris came over and he said, all right, let's do some experimenting. So hook the bass up, if you bring the camera over this way, hook the bass up into Avalon U5 here, right in there. Set the tone control where I would normally guess at it there. I would come over here. I went to Germanium Mic Pre. They sound wonderful, by the way. And then I went into what I typically would do for bass. We ran into a distressor, which I love. I typically would go to distortion 2 or distortion 3 on the bass and get the sound. So I got it where I thought, that's a good, really good bass sound. So it went basically straight into CLASP on the tape machine over here that we have. Got everything labeled so we know what's where. There's the bass track. And then we went input, got a great bass tone, and then Chris said, okay, man, I do go ahead and mute the EQ, turn off the distressor. So basically, you're just getting the level right and going straight into the 2-inch machine. So we did that, and he said, okay, man, I dare you, just let tape have tape compression. That's what it does. And so we did that, and then played it back off a repro, and it sounded like this. And so me being an engineer, I said, okay, I was bound and determined, I'm not going to let basically tape beat my ears. I can beat it. So we went back to input, I worked on the tone. I literally tried to match the tone that tape was actually giving me. EQ, best EQ, best compressor that I thought would be great. And I got the tone bigger and better, but every time I hit bypass and listened off a repro, I got spanked really hard. So I was beaten by the CLASP. I couldn't beat it. And two-inch tape machine, I said, okay, this is something really, really special here. So that was our experience. I know the artist, I think he has an interview, Michael W. Smith, has been moved, I mean, emotionally, because of the use of CLASP and going back and using analog tape. It's really, really been an amazing musical experience for this record. So we're excited for the record to release. And I want to tell the entire world that CLASP is the bomb. We already own one. I want to buy another one for Overdub. And I'm trying to figure out a way how I can incorporate it in my mixing. To me, it's been huge to have CLASP in our life, and I never, ever want to go back, I hate to say it, to digital. Back in the old days, when it was just analog recording, we didn't have to go through the DAW. If you're a singer, I guess the new singers of today have gotten used to having almost zero latency, but to me, it's a little bit of a phase. It's not true zero latency monitoring, and so you have to rely on your processor in your digital audio workstation until CLASP. So now with CLASP, the way that they monitor it, it's a true zero latency, and it switches back between input and actually repro. You play through the input while it's recording off the repro head, but everything's perfectly in sync. So like you say you record it, and then you're cutting your vocal. So he listens back what's been aligned and played off the repro head of tape. But as soon as you hit the record, it monitors in and out of CLASP through an analog console or whatever you have, that they match the levels input and output. And to me, on this record with Michael, it's really helped him sing because there's no latency or phase issues or anything like that. To me, it has really helped him sing on this record. And to me, it's much more musical. If you notice, here's how I can explain it to somebody in simple terms. When you record, you play on input. It's a true virgin transfer. It's about the difference in time. It comes through here. It's recorded on the piece of tape. Boop. This tape goes from here to here, and guess what? It's transferred instantly into your Pro Tools, Nuendo, Cubase, or whatever DAW you're using. So it's a true virgin transfer. It doesn't even have time to loop itself around. So there's no oxidation because it didn't have time to. It's like records and it's instantly converted. So that's how awesome it is. So you buy one reel of tape for a record. If you buy the CLASP, it would only take actually two or three records, and it's been bought and paid for just with the cost of even the tape alone. This is one major thing. In the old days, you either had to record at 30 IPS or 15 IPS. Once you started your record, you're locked in because you have to stripe it with Sympty. It's been an educational experience for me to be able to switch between 30 inches or 15 inches per second, or we can even vary speed down. This machine goes down to 11.2 inches per second and just experiment. So I typically will cut, depending on the song, we'll go between 30 and 15, maybe drums at 30, bass sounds better at 15, guitars at 15. It pretty much depends, whatever you want to do. You can align the top end and the low end in between songs to get a different sound. You can experiment. Almost, I hate to use the word effect, but you can slam it to tape and get more compression. You can back it off and you get less compression. Depends on whatever you want. So it's an amazing tool. So very flexible, and I hope that everybody just buys these things. And to me, it could definitely revolutionize just the history of music and the history of recording.